Today I would like to show you how I hide microphones in film and TV productions. I'm using DPA 4060 microphones in different placements on the actors because I believe that with correct choice of microphone and placement, I do not have to compensate with EQ in the recording. When it sounds natural, I know I placed the microphone correctly. Let me show you how. First, I'll place a microphone on a t-shirt. I'll show it on the outside of the t-shirt. Of course, it should be on the inside of the t-shirt. I'll take a piece of molten, place a microphone, and then place the microphone on the t-shirt. And I'll place a piece of molten here for eliminating cable noise. On this torso is another placement. I have used a DPA concealer taped on the body of the actor, and then I put some small pieces of fur for keeping distance to the t-shirt on the outside of the concealer. In this tie, I have placed a microphone wrapped in some molten, put it up here, and then placed a little piece of fur on the back of the tie to eliminate noise from the knot. Here's a microphone placed in the pencil. The microphone is there. On this shirt, I've placed a microphone behind the button. I took off the button, placed the microphone in the hole, and glued the button on the outside of the microphone. Another microphone is placed here. This is what I call edge mounting. Microphone is placed right to the edge with molten. On this jacket, I placed the microphone at the edge, and then I place a little piece of fur on the outside of the microphone to keep distance between the jacket and the shirt for eliminating scratching between the jacket and the shirt behind. On the other side of the jacket, I place a piece of molten at the edge just to keep down the noise from the fabrics scratching against each other. I'll show you the materials I use. I use molten, scene molten, in different colors for making these strips. On these strips, I have used some double-sided tape, and now I can use it for placing the microphones on the clothing. I use different types of fur, which is different colors, and make these strips for making pieces of fur to make distance between the microphone and the body, or the microphone and the cloth. With actors with sensitive skin, I use toupee tape for mounting microphones and concealers on the body. So be creative. For instance, I use this material from Chrysler Benz. It is sound damping material for their vents, and I use it for making the microphones less shiny with little pieces of this, or as wind jammers.
Another good way to hide a microphone on an actor is to hide it in the hair. For this purpose, tension springs provide an easy fixture. Benefits are the hair's natural windscreen properties, great sound, and that the mic is invisible to the camera.
So, anything goes, as long as it sounds natural.